Hi, I'm John Levinsold for killerphp.com, and in this video what I'm going to do is essentially bring together a lot of the examples that we've been looking at and try and make a very simple piece that will, it's going to essentially be a hero. Now, a hero in marketing terms is this banner image with usually a couple different options at the bottom. It's, you know, like an interactive banner on a website. So we're going to build that. We're going to strip out a lot of the kind of content stuff that we've done in the other videos and focus exclusively on how we can use some advanced CSS effects to generate something that looks pretty good. And then from there, we're going to take that into the realm of video. So let's get started. So what you're seeing right now is a very simple, well, it's actually the video, or it's actually the page that we did in the last video. And so what I'm going to do is start off by actually stripping out a lot of the content that we did in the last video. So I'm going to get rid of the footer, and I'm going to get rid of the whole container section. Hit save, refresh this page, and now we're just getting the Acme website, the tagline. In fact, I'm even going to take that out so that all that will remain, and we're going to also get rid of these fonts. So all we're going to have is essentially this top navigation that we've put together in the last video. Now, with just that in place, we're going to build out our hero. And you'll see very quickly what I mean when I say a hero. So it's going to be a section. And inside, I'm going to have, this is going to be for a car website. So I'm just going to say class, we'll call it car, H1, another car website, or another car site. And then we'll have another nav tag inside here. And it'll be the same sort of thing, except we're going to have an unordered list with some options. And that's it. So some very simple markup. Basically, if I go back here and I refresh this page, you're just going to see another car site, and then you're going to see another nav that looks identical to the one on top. And that's it. So now let's actually get into the meat of it, which is going to be styling this guy. So we like our nav on top. I don't think we're going to change much of that. That looks fine. But now we're going to focus on this hero section. So first thing I'm going to do is, actually I'll add a class here calling it hero. And we're going to take out a lot. We're going to use the Annabelle script, so I'm going to keep that. But anything related to the articles, anything related to a site, and by the way, this is a huge advantage of making sure that you indent your CSS, because then it's very easy for you to figure out what belongs to what exactly. So now we have this header section. Again, I can delete that. But we do still have a nav, so I want to make sure that that is respected. Open that up. Delete that. Go back, refresh. Nothing should change, and that's good. So now we've got only the CSS relevant to this current page. Now, let's start styling it. So in section, so here, in section.hero, I'm going to specify a width. Let's say, I don't know, let's say 800 pixels, a height of 300 pixels. Want to make it center. Want to make sure it's display block. Add a top margin of 30 pixels. I'm going to add a background to it. You've seen me do this so many times now, so basically we're adding a gradient. It's going to start in the center bottom. So it's going to start in the bottom. And we're going to start with a dark blue at 0%. And we're going to go to a lighter blue, more of a purple actually, because there's going to be equal amounts or almost equal amounts of blue and purple. Hit save. Let's see what happens. Already we're getting something a little nicer. So we've got this gradient happening, and we've got another car site. I'm also going to add a border radius. So now we're getting some rounded corners, which is kind of nice. And now I want to start playing with the actual font heading. So again, we're going to use the, you know, the knowledge that we gained in the last tutorial where we were dealing with fonts and our font face section, which I seem to have lost my at font face. I'm going to add that back, at font face. There we go. So in section hero, that's fine. And now we're going to go section.hero h1. And we want to style this with a font family of Annabelle script. And if the person doesn't have Annabelle script for whatever reason, then we'll just default to Arial and sans serif. And we'll set a really high font size and a color of white. Alright. Oops. Okay, so far so good. I'm going to make it italic. This is also to show you that even though you've embedded a special font, you can still treat it like any other font. You can make it italic, you can make it bold, you can do whatever you need to do with it. And then I'm just going to add some padding all around. Alright, very good.